Fancy My Baby Thrift Store. How may I help you today? It's your first time. Wonderful. Well, welcome. Yes, baby thrifting is actually quite popular between many parents, and it's becoming more and more popular as you can save at least half of your money than purchasing a brand new toy. We know that kids don't play with the same toy for long, so this way you don't waste your money. Plus, you can resell it or give it down the line to your friends or family. Then, of course, it's much more earth-friendly as less trash is acquired. And you get many more choices, I feel like, and sometimes even better ideas of what your kid might like and try. So, that's right, you gave me a call. Mm-hmm. Yes, I have a few different toys that you have been acquiring about, so we can definitely go over them. Mm-hmm. How old's your baby? It's a great age. They're so sweet, so cuddly and babbly, aren't they? Yeah, I have a daughter too, yeah. So, one of the things I remember you wanted to see is crinkle toys. Babies and adults, let's just say that. We all love little crinkles. I have this one perfect for you. And it's a stacking circle tower. You can see different colors that you can guys play with and name, of course. You've got rainbow tags that you can pull on and tag on. And then it has these little circles that you would stack on top of each other. So there's one, two, three, four, and then five is our base. We have yellow color, with colorful lines on the fabric, and ribbed edging. Very nice. We have orange. A different fabric now. You will notice that it's not an annoying crinkle, it's actually quite pleasant. Mm-hmm. So then we have this red circle. It has a more smooth fabric on it. And then the surroundings are slightly fluffier texture. Big circle, that's purple. Mm-hmm. Another texture here too. My daughter is a little too small right now. She doesn't really stack as well yet. She's trying to, but not fully yet. So what we do is we sometimes color coordinate our different bowls that we have, or cubes. Becomes like a platform for it. Imagination, right? So, this one is an option. Definitely stimulates a few different senses. Mm-hmm. Okay. I also have this little book. It's appropriate for all ages. So, from the very start too. Mm-hmm. And it's a very sweet book about a doggy named Buddy and about his busy day. Yeah. practice and talk about his day and how it's similar to your guys' day, how he plays, then goes back home, takes a little bath, gets nice and clean, and then he goes to sleep. Like a good boy. This book does have lots of taggies. If your kid is into tags, lots of kids love tags. Little loops. So that's a pretty good option for you as well, if you wish. Some free play items, very simple, you'll be amazed. Just a scarf. You can get them textured, you can get a regular scarf, you might even have something at home already too. So with scarves like this, you can look for texture, right? It's nice and smooth, and you name it and talk about it. You can see different colors, you can play peekaboo. Look how transparent it is. You can use it as a cape and be a superhero. Or you can hide something. Oh, where'd it go? There it is. Sometimes free play with simple objects, such as just scarves or just a box, can be extremely important to the development of your baby. And it's so simple, right? Almost costs no money. Okay, so that's just another option for you, is a simple scarf. Some people call them silks, but you can find different types, even just scraps of fabric will do. So books like this last quite a while as well. Just change the batteries and you're good to go. I won't turn on the sound here, but you do have two settings of just music, and you have a flashing light. You can press these buttons and it works like a piano, so you can just play notes. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si. Or you can turn it into book mode, and it will sing songs, speak out loud colors and different instruments that you see here. Right here. It also has these little moving pieces. Here the same. These are very easy to flip for kids after 6 months. Got more moving pieces here. They make a nice, quite loud noise, like gear turning noise. And my daughter absolutely loved that. And then we have more here. So it's quite engaging and helps fine motor skills and finger-pincer development as well. So this is a good option, okay? If you're into colorful toys, of course, there's a lot of different opinions out there and different techniques to parent. Look at this one, it's a good example. Here's one of the popular Montessori toys. And Montessori, I'm not fully educated on, but it's basically So if you push a button, it plays the song for you. So it's considered that these lack imagination promotion and creativity, as these colorful toys that flashing lights and such, they already entertain them without almost forcing them, well, enforcing them into creativity. And I personally believe that there's a middle to everything, and you can combine both types of toys. So this is a Montessori toy as well, and we have that too. And it basically features these four little men here. They're different colors. There's so different, so many different variations of this toy as well. So you can really choose and pick whatever you like. Okay. It's nice and wooden, so it's going to withstand through ages. Okay. And the key engagement here is pulling out one of them. My daughter really likes to mention them, yeah. Still, it's it could cause a little bit of gagging, but they won't choke on it. Okay, so that the key engagement is for them to grip it, pull it out, and then once they have a few of them out, you need to help them organize it by color. So blue goes with blue, red goes with red, yellow with yellow, green goes with green. Then once they have understood this concept, they will notice that they bubble a little bit. And you need to teach them how to catapult these. I'll show you. I hope it will work. One more time. And they shoot out like so. So these are quite entertaining for kids too. So you can see how this toy is, of course, encourages more creativity and more organized play than versus this book, for example, which again we also love and play with as well, which doesn't really encourage as much movement, although I honestly find middle ground to be the best. We'll move on from there. Okay, so what do you think about this story? It's a good option then, yeah? Okay. How about some soft toys? So, this is a soft toy. Of course, soft toys are my charter to keep clean and to last longer without stains and just for them not to be beat up. But it is doable too. Some toys you can wash in a washer, which is super convenient. Okay. So this here is a hedgehog. He has crazy hair. Spikes, I should say. His needles. And my daughter loves to hug him and kiss him and cuddle with him. I think it's very sweet. So yeah, that's the type of soft toys that we have here too. Okay. Must be a huge truck outside. Okay. So then for free play, we also have some foam blocks. And these are just samples of them. of these different shapes as well, so the kids can play with them and maybe stack all the orange squares together. These green triangles. My daughter loves to chew on them. You will see lots of little teeth marks. I have some diamond. Yes. So these are also easy, free play toy. Quite easy to store as well because they're quite soft. And then you can do different projects with them later. Since they're foam, you can do cutouts if you wish. So that's always an option. Okay. You want to look at books? Okay. So as far as books goes, all kids are different. Different kids love different toys, different books, different styles. So this book is perfect as an early introduction to books for babies. And this first 100 words. There are some essential words and then some of more in-depth items. But for the most part, these are some of the things that baby will see or come in contact with during their first year, I would say. And as you name these things in your everyday life and then see them in the book, it reinforces the baby to see the world, to understand it, to recognize patterns and similar things, okay? So different types of babies and activities of babies, all very important for their speaking skills. There are also lots of classic books, and we have a few of these. There are, I think, over 200 different ones that you can pick and choose from. Here I have Peter Pan, a Jungle Book, and Winnie the Pooh and the Honey Tree. Okay? And these are just classic books with pictures and illustrations, just like in the cartoon that you remember. In a convenient way of a small book that you can take with you and you can read together and point and describe also colors and such. I also get them in the thrift shop and they cost not more than $2 each. So that's that. So I think it's a good idea to start teaching them about some classic fairy tales and stories from our childhood too. I thought that's wooden blocks. And you, of course, want to get the ones with non-toxic paint in them, especially if your baby is still teething and mouthing everything. So I have these ones in different colors. And one with no color, of course, too. They're just so universal and versatile. Same thing, it's free play, lots of imagination, lots of different concepts that could be learned. You can do counting with them. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can do color coordination, color groups, and you can stack. This you can do different shapes, of course, and you can combine it with other toys as well. So cubes, very, very universal. My daughter is trying to figure them out. So far, she dislikes the clinking sounds. So that's very nice and endearing as well. So that's the blocks. Of course, if you're interested. We also like trains. Lots of babies love wheels. Some babies are very fascinated by wheels. So we have this train here. They can actually stack cubes right on top. I do like that sound too. For smaller babies, soft rattles like this are just perfect, especially if there's a little face where you get a little smile and eyes for the baby to focus on and becomes a little friend that makes a noise. I like this one because you can hang it on different things, suspend it, and it can hang above your baby when you're playing with them. Of course, there's lots of baby toys of this style. Okay. Then similar to cubes, you have to have lots of different bowls. Bowls for days. Different texture bowls, different shapes, colors, and purposes. So I have this type of bowl, which is has lots of texture inside. It's actually quite smooth on the outside. It has a very nice sound to it too, if you throw it or touch it. Very pleasant. That of course inflatable bowls too. And this one's actually deflated, which my daughter loved right away because she could grab it and squeeze it like this. And it's a very interesting feeling. It has the little boop-de-doops that she can play with and try to figure out how to rip it off, which doesn't work. These spiky balls, which are great for sensory feelings and associations. Yeah. There's also light that lights up sometimes, if you wish it to. They come in different colors as well. They have little spikes that you can chew on and try pressing in different things. Then there is a ball like this. Quite amusing to play with it. She loves to squeeze it like this and then try chewing on it. So babies love these types of balls that they can hold in their hand and then just play with like so. Okay, so what do you think? You like it? Mm-hmm. Yes, I can of course gift you the basket as well. Quite stretchy, so you can put lots of things in it. Mm-hmm. Okay. I also have this owl. It actually has a little bit of sound to it. I might turn can also hear the sensor going because it's a never falling toy. And it has little crinkle wings. This crinkle is much stronger than anything that we have seen today. But it has beautiful bright eyes and a little pecker, so your baby can really make eye contact with it and make friends with it. They usually love to just see it roll around. Okay? So what do you think? Do you have any other questions? Are there certain gifts here, toys that you have enjoyed and would like to purchase? Okay, sounds good. That's great choices. Mm-hmm. Well, I have a reusable bag. Yeah, give it back. Instead of plastic material one. So I'll place everything in it, okay? Also, would you like me to wipe down some of these items? So this book is so important. Some of those first words are the first that you can hear from your baby, how exciting and important it is to hear them voice it out and see that they recognize the world around them. It's very, very exciting. I'm sure your baby will love this one. Okay? You said the cues, right? Do you like all four? Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely easier to play with four of them. Yes, correct. There's not much care that needs to be done. Just, you know, watch out for pieces of chopped color paint. Make sure that nothing like that happens and they don't ingest it directly. So, I'll just put them right there. Yep. Just line them up for you nice and carefully. Okay. I'll just tie up here. Here's your bag of goodies. Thank you so much for coming over. I hope you enjoy it and come